Even though vector fields and manifolds belong to two different branches of mathematics, they have something beautiful in common. What is a vector field anyway? It is a collection of vectors indicating the direction and magnitude of the movement of an entity, whereas a manifold is a topological space that is locally Euclidean. Before understanding the relation between the two, let's understand the field that ties these two together, topology. Topology deals with shapes that retain their properties even after continuous deformation. However, these shapes cannot be cut or glued. The binding force of this relation is the Euler characteristic of topological manifolds. In geometry, the Euler's formula is used to determine the relationship between the faces, the edges, and the vertices of polyhedra. The Euler characteristic is denoted by the Greek symbol chi and given by the formula vertices minus edges plus faces. For a sphere, the Euler characteristic can be found by dividing it in geodesic triangles. Here, there are 4 vertices, 6 edges and 4 faces. The value of chi would be 2. This would remain the same regardless of the way we calculate it. It is topologically equivalent to a cube. Hence, the sphere and the cube are homeomorphic. Manifolds that preserve their topological properties through continuous deformations are known as homeomorphic. Since these shapes are homeomorphic, they have the same Euler characteristic of 2. Even a tetrahedron is homeomorphic to a sphere and a cube and has the same characteristic. Hence, the Euler characteristic is known to be an invariant, as it remains unchanged through continuous deformation of a manifold. Now, let's talk about vector fields. The sphere shown has 2 critical points. The type of vector field formed here is a circulation. We can calculate the index value of the circulation by drawing the vector field, labeling each instance of the vectors using numbers. We can imagine dials rotating counterclockwise as shown with the orientations below. Pause the video to correlate the numbers. As a rule, counterclockwise revolutions are counted as positive and have an index value of +1. Here, the two circulations both have an index value of +1. The sum of these index values is surprisingly the Euler characteristic of the sphere. We can check this by drawing the vector fields in a different manner, now creating a source and a sink. A source and a sink also have an index value of +1, giving us a total value of 2 again. This formula sums up the discussion so far. It shows the sum of the indices of a vector field at the critical points and its equivalence with the Euler characteristic of the manifold M. This is called the Poincaré-Hopf theorem. Indices of vector fields form a part of physical concepts like motion of matter, whereas manifolds are purely topological. This relation provides a link between two fields that seem to have nothing in common.